Good morning, student. I'm Rose. Today we are in the ninth session of this chapter, that is chapter 7, History, chapter 3, the Sultans of Delhi. Okay, in the last 8 videos, we have learned different kinds of kings or the sultans who ruled over India, or we can say ruled over the Delhi. Yes or no? So today we are going to learn how do we get the information about the Sultans of Delhi. Okay, how do we get the information of the Sultans of Delhi? Okay, so mainly as we know, if you study the history or if you want to know about something, mainly we about the past, or we can say about the last few years, or we can say most 2000 years back. Mainly we can find from the inscriptions, there you have the coins and the architecture, or the architecture. So these three are the main important source from where we get the information about the past. And if you talk about this chapter, or we can say about the Sultans of Delhi, if you want to talk about the Delhi Sultanate, we mainly found something about, we get information from the inscriptions also, coins also, and the architecture also. And some of the most important one, that is the more important source, that is called the Tarikh. So this is a Persian language. If it is singular, we call the Tarikh, and in the plural, we call the Tuarikh. Okay. So if you talk about what is Tarikh, what we call these are the historiographic and history written by the learned man. Okay. So actually, this Tarikh, if you talk, it is a Persian, or we can say Turkish language, in which we say the date. Call the date. It is a date. Yes or no? Tarikh. If you talk about it in Hindi, we call the Tarikh. Yes or no? So this Tarikh actually means the date. Means which time, where, how, where it happened. Okay. So these are all included in the Tarikh. That means where, how, when, at what time, or we can say who. Okay. So these are the question arises about the Tarikh. Okay. At what time of prayer? Who was that time of prayer? Where was the place during that period? Yes or no? So these are called the Tarikh. Okay. So this Tarikh was actually containing a history written by the learned man. So these, who are the learned man if you talk about? Who are the learned man? They can be a scholar. They can be a secretaries of the sultans. They can be an administrator of the sultans or the kingdom. They can be a poet. They can be a courtier. Courtiers means we can say the minister who's in office, or we can say present in the king's court. Okay, so these are the people who were called as the learned men. Okay, so these are people write the Tarikh during the time period of the any king or any sultans. Okay, so that is called the Tarikh. So these are the main sources from where we get the information about the sultans of Delhi. Okay, so if you talk about this, Tarikh is similar to the manuscript. If you talk about the manuscript, it is one type of paper in which the people, or we can say the learned man or the scholar, used to write on that page, or we can say paper. Okay, so this Tarikh was actually similar to the manuscript. Okay, it was same as the manuscript. Okay, so if you talk about how they used to write the manuscript, or how they used to make, what is the process of making the manuscript? If you talk about, first of all, the first step they used, or we can say they do, was preparing the paper. So first process, by using a palm leaves, or by using a bamboo, or how they prepare the paper. The second process, writing the text. That means when they have already prepared the paper, okay, when they have already prepared the paper, as you write on the copy, yes or no? So they used to prepare the paper, okay, with the raw material or something like that, okay. They were not having this kind of pages. But they used to have the pages, okay, even in the cloth they used to write, or they used to prepare the page, and on that they used to write whichever they are the things they used to, they are going to write, okay. So they were called the text. Okay, so when they used to write anything, that was called the text. Another is the, when they go to highlight. having the ink. Yes or no? They used to do, first of all, the ink was, they used to write with the, what we call, bird's feather. Yes or no? Bird's feather and the quill we call, quill. Okay, yes or no? With that, they used to put the ink, they used to write. Yes or no? So this, when they used to melt the gold, okay, then it was in the form of an ink, in the golden color. Okay, the golden color in the form of a liquid. And they used to, whichever word is to highlight, they used to write it with the melted gold. Okay, melted gold. So this is how the important words are being highlighted by the melted gold on the paper. Another, preparing the binding. After that, what they used to bind the paper. For example, in the movie or in the bind it, okay, and bind it, and they used to keep in the archive or in the library. So this is how they used to prepare the manuscript or any any paper or any passages in the text, or we can say they used to keep in the, but after preparing that, they used to keep in the archive very safe and sound. So this is how they used to prepare. First of all, prepare the paper. Next, writing the text. What's the important thing they have to write? Another is the, when they used to highlight any word, they used to melt the gold, and with the melted gold or in the form of a liquid gold, they used to write on the paper. Another is the, they used, they preparing the binding. That means fourth point is preparing the binding. That means when they have already completed and it is already dry, they used to bind it and keep it safe and sound in the archive. So this is how we, these are the four stages how to prepare the manuscript or making of the manuscript. Another topic we will go, some details should be kept in the mind with the regard to tarikh and the authors. Okay, so actually the writers or the authors, those who used to write the tarikh, or we can say message, or we can say the history. So what they used to do, the authors of the tarikh live in the cities, mainly in Delhi, and hardly ever in village. So these people are the secretary or the administrator or the poet or the courtiers who used to write the tarikh, they usually live in the city. Usually live in the city, mainly in the Delhi. Okay, so they actually write only about the kings and the cities of the Delhi, and they don't even very rare case you can see about the lifestyle of the people of the village, what are the conditions or what are the development in the village, they cannot write about this, all this. Okay, so that is why only they write about the live in the city. Due to that, they can only mainly write about, or we can say tell about the cities of the place where they live. Okay, another point is that they often brought their history for Sultan in the hope of reaching God. Okay, so what they used to do, this people, the authors, what they used to do, they mainly write about the sultans, or we can say administration, or we can say praise of the sultans or any king, so that they can, by hearing this, the sultans or any king could give them a proper, or we can say, give them a proper reward, or we can say a gift, or we can say rich reward to them. So they were so much clever. Okay, so they doesn't write a bad word, or we can say what are the infacilities which is given by the sultans, or how the rule and regulation. Instead of that, they write about the praise, or we can say without any reason, just they praise it. Whether however the king may be or the sultan may be, they will write more about the praise of the sultan or his kingdom. So this, with this, the king or the sultan also used to be so much happy. Due to that, what happens? They used to get the rich reward. Okay. So these authors they often wrote the stories for the sultan in the hope of rich reward. Okay. So this was the cleverness of the sultans. Okay. Another point, this author advised to rulers on the need to preserve an ideal and social order based on birth Either that means from where this where any king or any what we call any sultans, he's from Afghanistan or maybe from India. So what they used to do? They used to write on the we can say preserve an idol like social order based on the birthright and the gender distinction. Birthright and the gender distinction they used to birthright and gender distinction. Okay, so they used to preserve on the base of the birthright. This is the last point. Preserve in the form of a birthright as a gender distinction. So what they used to, from wherever the background it is, how is the sultan or from where he is come, they used to keep or preserve. From which background he is coming, or we can say how he was, or we can say whether it is a male or female, okay, so whether it is how much powerful or something like that. So they used to preserve it with the birthright and the gender distinction. So this is how this topic.